Hello learners, I, Pallavi Joshi from Pune Institute of Computer Technology, Pune, welcome you all for the lecture series on object-oriented programming in Python. Today, we are going to focus on the further features of object-oriented programming. Till now, we are done with classes, objects, methods, message passing, inheritance and polymorphism. Today's points of discussion includes containership, reusability and delegation. And the most important concept, data abstraction and encapsulation, will be discussing in tomorrow's lecture. To begin with containership, reusability and delegation, these are the smaller but still important topic of object-oriented paradigm. Containership. Now the name itself suggests that something is going to get contained in some other object or some other thing. Now this is a general discussion. Talking in terms of object-oriented, we always have to take help of a class. Now you all know that class is a skeleton which contains attributes and the operations. Attributes are the data members and operations are the member functions. Now these attributes and operations are helpful for an object to initiate itself. So they are written specifically for the object. Now containership is an ability of a class to contain objects of one or more class as a data member. For example, one class can have an object of class 2 as its data member. We shall elaborate this by taking an example. So let's have a class A which has few attributes and few functions. There is no need to know about the attributes and the functions of class A. We have another class B. Now, there are two statements which are visible in class B, and I hope you identify those statements. Students, those are the statements which tells you about the creation of object. Both these statements are different, but the purpose is same. So in the first statement, we are writing capital A space small a. So capital A is the name of class, which is class A, and the small a is an object. So this is the first way of creating an object wherein a object is created which belongs to class A. But where this object is created? It is created in class B. In the same way, AA is an object is created of class A. This is way 2 of creating an object in Python. This is the significant way in Python itself. So both these methods are creating an object. In the first way, small a is an object. In the second way, this AA is an object which belongs to class A. But these objects are created in class B. And now these objects of class A can make use the methods of class. Now this class A is called as contained class, which is contained inside class B, and class B is called as a container class. Learning something more about containership. So this would allow the object of class 1 to call the public function of class 2. So using object of class 1, the public functions of class 2 can be accessed. Here class 1 becomes the container, whereas class 2 becomes the content class. Containership is also called as composition, and containership has a relationship. The difference between containership and inheritance. Containership, when feature of existing class are wanted inside our new class, but not its interface. We do not want the interface but we want their features only. For example, we can say a computer system has a hard disk, a car has an engine, chassis, steering wheels. So as we have already discussed, that containership includes has a relationship. So whenever we say a computer system has a hard disk, means this is a containership feature involved. Car has an engine, chassis, steering wheel, etc. Now the difference between a containership and inheritance goes like inheritance. When you want to force the new type to be the same type as the base one. So we want the derived class as this of the same type of the base class. So there is a possibility that inheritance relation is executed there. And when we do not want it to be a forced copy of the base class, it can be a containership. Now inheritance, computer system is an electronic device. So electronic device can be a class whose derived class is computer. Now car is a vehicle. Vehicle can be a base class where car is a subclass of the vehicle class. So this is an best example of inheritance and containership, stating their differences. One more difference diagrammatically represented as, where inheritance relationship is shown in the figure, in the first half of the figure, vehicle and car, and containership feature is shown in the later half of the figure, whereas engine, tire, steering wheels are the part of the car which are contained in the car class, whereas a car is a vehicle. Now stating something more about the containership. For example, you are a programmer, you have generated a code which is very important for the future reference. Now your best friend wants the result of that code. Now what you would do? Your best friend wants the code, you want that the code should be helping to your best friend also, but then you still do not want to give the complete access to the code because that is something significant which you have written. Now one solution to this is, you can give the link of the executable of your code, so as it solves the purpose of your friend who only wants the result, who is not interested in your code, and you also safeguard your code in going into unnecessary hands, or it should not be local, or it should not be available for other public to manipulate and use. So the link which you provide to your friend is serving the purpose of the object. So you can say that you are not giving access to the complete code of your class, but you are only going to give an access through a object. Reusability, very important and short feature of Python or any object oriented programming language, which we have understood in n number of concepts which we have learned till now. Inheritance, polymorphism, everything solves the same purpose of reusability, where we do not rewrite the code but we reuse the code once written. Reusability means developing code that can be reused either in the same program or in the different programs. Python gives due importance to building programs that are reusable. Reusability is attained through inheritance, containership and polymorphism. The next important topic is delegation. There is a slight difference between containership and delegation, but both of them has a relationship. Now what is delegation? Again, as per the name suggests, it delegates its work to its subordinates. For example, to provide maximum flexibility to programmer and to allow them to generate reusable codes, object-oriented language also supports delegation. Now how? In composition, an object can be composed of other objects, and thus the object exhibits has a relationship. Composition here means containership. In delegation, more than one object is involved in handling a request. So it is a has a relationship in containership, where one object is defined or is generated in altogether different class. In delegation, there is no it's not about only one object. There are n number of objects which are generated so as to solve the purpose, so as to solve a one larger task. The object that receives a request for a service delegate it to another object called a delegate. So you can understand the importance of this feature delegation by this one statement. One object who receives the request for a service. So if at all I say I want this job to be done, if I give the task to your CR, then CR in turn delegate that job to n number of students present in the class. So n number of students present in the class becomes the delegate. For me, your CR becomes the delegate. For your CR, the students becomes the delegate. The property of delegation emphasizes on the ideology that complex object is made of several simpler objects. True. For example, our body is made up of our brain, heart, hands, eyes, ears, etc. N number of other systems and the tissues. So whenever there is a need, if you are listening a video, listening an audio lecture, you require your ears to be in the motion or ears to have that listening capability. So your brain in turn will signal your ears to take that job. If you are watching a video, then your brain will signal your eyes also to get involved. Likewise, n number of tasks or any request which is received to your body, your brain delegate that job to a particular part of your body. The functioning of the whole body as a system rests on the correct functioning of the parts it is composed of. It is true. So when your delegates are working fine, you can be sure that your complete system is working fine. Similarly, a car has a wheel, brake, gears, etc. to control it. Delegation differs from inheritance in the way that two classes that participate in inheritance share is a relationship. However, in delegation, they have has a relationship. So truly, containership and delegation has a relationship, and inheritance has is a relationship. So that's all about containership, reusability and delegation. In the next lecture, we'll be discussing on data abstraction and encapsulation. Thank you for watching.